Well, what's happening? Hope we're all good. Thanks for tuning in and watching this video. In this video, I'm going to be taking you through the game day preparations. So game weekend from our Tailtean Cup Quarter Final against Carlo. But just want to jump on quickly before we get stuck into it. So I'm currently sat here editing the video, but just realized some of the clips are not all over the show, but the camera's off, the angle's different, so some of them are like this, when it probably should be like this. So this video, the clips for this video was actually recorded before the first video I put on YouTube. So you might have watched the first one already, but this one was actually recorded before that. So yeah, still getting the grips with the camera angles and whatnot, so please forgive me. But yeah, hope you enjoyed it anyway, taking you through game weekend, as I say. So starting on the Friday, taking you through the Saturday carb load, primer session on Saturday, and then what I do in game day as well, different routines, eating, all that sort of crack. So yeah, hope you enjoy it, hope you take plenty from it. Thanks again for tuning in and watching, appreciate the support. So yeah, feel free to share, subscribe, like, comment, all that sort of crack. And if there's anything you actually want to see on the channel going forward, please let me know, and I'll be happy to take some ideas on board. So yeah, cheers for watching, hope you enjoy.
What's happening? So in this video, I'm going to be running you through a typical game weekend in preparation for our Tailtean Cup quarterfinal against Carlo on Sunday. It's currently Friday today. We've trained tonight, our last training session of the week. I'm currently getting my pre-training meal in, my Cocoa Pops, and I got a bit of yogurt on the side. So yeah, Friday today, carb load tomorrow, bit of a primer. I'm going to be bringing you through the weekend to show you what I get up to, how I prepare for games, and how I give myself the best possible chance of performing come game day. So enjoy.
Just trying to do a fancy wee edit here, making my pre-training meal. So I have my Cocoa Pops, as you saw, have yogurt with berries, bit of honey in there, and then probably closer to training, have a square bar, coffee, get ready to go. Nothing too intense this week, just keeping things sort of sharp, keeping things fresh with obviously the game coming up the weekend. So out the door, in the training, and then I'll run you through Saturday coming right up.
Saturday morning, game tomorrow. We had team training last night, final team session before the game. Today then, Saturday, we're going to go through carb load and we're going to go through our primer session. Just filling up the carb stores for the game tomorrow, obviously. So the day before the game is your biggest day of eating. And then game day itself, you're still eating enough, but it's not as big as your carb load day. You're getting all that work done the day before. So going to take you through that today. Starting off with breakfast here is just after 8. So starting with oats and a smoothie on the side. About 120 grams of oats in it, banana, all the rest of it. So plenty of carbs there. So when it comes to the porridge, first meal of the day, we go normal porridge. So 85 grams of oats in there, made with water and honey on the top. And then we go for a smoothie on the side. So exact same ingredients as you would use for protein porridge, but just far easier to get in. So as I say, 85 grams of oats in the porridge, made with water and honey. And then the shake is almond milk, vanilla protein, usually go chocolate, but don't have any chocolate left. Banana, oats, another 35 grams of oats, so 120 grams of oats all in. And then frozen blueberries as well. So as I say, same ingredients that would go into a bowl of protein oats, overnight oats, whatever it is, but it's far easier to get in when you eat it like that. And I don't know, something really great about like just normal oats with honey. Don't know if it's sick or twisted, but it's fucking amazing.
As you can see, after breakfast, washing it down with a lovely morning coffee before getting into a Saturday morning work block here. So over game weekend, I want to try and keep the schedule as close to normal as possible. Usually when you have too much time and you think of game weekend, a lot of the time, well, I used to do it anyway. I used to sit about, think about the game a lot and just not really get up to anything. And I actually found myself feeling a wee bit flatter, having less energy. So just be sort of keeping myself busy, but not to the extent where I'm fried or almost like burning myself out. Just be keeping myself busy, going about my weekend as normal, doing a wee bit of work, getting out and about, going for a walk, and just having a bit of a life as well, like not spending the whole weekend thinking about the match. It almost gives me more energy and gives me more freedom to, so that when it comes to the game time, I'm just ready to go and focused on it. I haven't been panicking or worrying about it over the whole weekend.
So just landed at the gym here. So we're on Saturday, we started our carb load. We've got two meals in so far today. So we had our porridge or oats this morning. We had scrambled eggs on toast with a bagel on the side for lunch, and then a square bar for a snack. So in the primer here in the gym now, we've got a good bit of mobility, a couple of jumps,
just to get sort of CNS activated and feeling good. So nothing too mental, nice light jumps, wee bit of upper body, just nice explosive bench press, add in a few curls as well, just to feel good. So as I say, nothing too mental, in and out 30-40 minutes, just to keep praying, keep sort of activated, and make sure we feel good tomorrow then for the game. So Premier just wrapped up, and you'll see it there on the last clip. So pretty simple, went through a good warm-up, good load of mobility, especially around the hips, hamstrings, lower back, just getting nice and loose. Been sitting quite a bit today, so just making sure that we're feeling free and not restricted a lot. And then into some jumps, so we're doing a trap bar jump, nice double contact on the ground, and then sort of spring it up from there, and then straight into a box jump, then again double contact, just making use of the stretch shortening cycle. Essentially you're going to get a bit more height out of your jump then. Just one thing on the box jump, so have a look at where my hips are and notice that I'm landing with a relatively straight leg on the box. So with box jumps, your goal is, well, the box is actually there to reduce the forces of the landing, but with your goal in box jumps, you're looking to get your hips as high as possible. So essentially hip displacement, you call it, trying to displace your hips as high as possible into the air rather than having a really, really high box. And you jump up, your hips don't actually go any higher, you're just able to bring your knees towards your chest and land in this high box. Looks fucking class on Instagram, but it's pointless. You may as well just jump the same height with your hips and land with straighter legs, the same way you would kind of land nice and stiff. If you're going up the jump to catch a ball, you want to land stiff so that you can then change direction or re-accelerate in whatever direction you want to go. So yeah, there's a bit of education for you. So after your jumps then, went into a bit of bench press, nice and light, about 70%, just moving as fast as we can on the way up, being as explosive as possible. Paired them up with explosive press ups, plyo push ups. It's not really a plyo, so we'll go explosive press up, just on the bench, so elevated a wee bit, bit of a drop in there, and then explode up off the bench. Just feels good, nice bit of explosive work in there as well. And then, as always, as you should with any session, finished off with a good bit of arms. Four sets, aimed for 8 to 12 reps. Started off with hammer curls, two sets of hammer curls at 17.5s. Been trying to add in a bit of arms after every session. Want to get the noodle arms a wee bit bigger. So, yeah, got 12 reps, 10 reps, and then went into a single arm curl. I think I got between, I think about 7 or 8 reps on the single arm at 17, so dropped it down to 15. And got the 8 reps each side there, so a bit tight, bit of a struggle, but yeah, as I say, in and out 40 minutes. I'll go home now, eat a bit of food, and get the rest of my steps in for the day. Then have a few wee things fucking about the house, have to get sorted, and yeah, then I get a big feed tonight. Stay tuned for the evening carb load meal. It's gonna be a cracker, the absolute goat.
So just sitting down to dinner here, and we've got our biggest meal of the day for our carb load. So this one, it's basically in our carb load day, trying to hit about 600 grams of carbs. And tonight, so for dinner, is my go-to. We've got homemade burritos. So we've got chicken, we've got a bag of microwave rice, mixed peppers, a bit of seasoning in there as well. And then we've got obviously our tortillas, four of them. So this meal is about 1200 calories, and I think it's about 170-180 grams of carbs. Really easy to eat, tasty, and just you feel full, you feel good after it, and it's a nice feed on a Saturday night. Like, so yeah, looking forward to getting stuck in it. This is my go-to meal the night before any game, and probably had it before every game this year without fail. So yeah, looking forward to it. So final meal of the day, the goat Cocoa Pops, 150 grams. I'm gonna split it up into two bowls, 175 grams each. Go-to cereal, tastes nice, easy to eat, plenty of carbs. And then I make that with almond milk, keep the calories down, and
normal, just doesn't sit well with me anyway. But yeah, I have one bowl and then another bowl, and it just makes me feel as if I'm getting a wee bit more as well. But yeah, watch this, eat this, watch a bit of TV, and chill out.
So it's Sunday morning here, game day. We're 7:15. I'm just getting the first meal of the day and breakfast time, playing obviously Carb Load today in the Tailtean Cup Quarter Final. Absolutely buzzing for it, but yeah, up at 7, just keeping the day as normal as possible, getting a good breakfast into me. Throw-ins at 1, which is a wee bit tricky. Normally even the extra hour works out a wee bit better. But glad that you'd rather get your match done at 1 on a Sunday than 4 o'clock or 5 o'clock. So yeah, just having the first meal here. What I like to do on game day is work backwards from the throw-in. So obviously yesterday was my Carb Load day, showed you through that. I've got most of my fueling done from there. So today it's just about sort of keeping things topped up, and I suppose just probably personal preference is key here. Yes, you still want to be getting a good amount of carbs in, but you've got probably enough in yesterday to last you, like you haven't done anything strenuous overnight that you've used up all the carbs. So yeah, with personal preference on game days is probably key. As long as you're feeling good, you're feeling almost like light and tight. Nutritionist Chris Lowe that I work with, that's the way he likes to describe it, and I think it works pretty well. But yeah, so basically, say throwing today is 1 o'clock, but say for example, yeah, but just use that example. So today is 1 o'clock. So what I like to do is like a 6 or 7 hour window. Now Chris, again, nutritionist, he recommends a 6 hour window, but it's again personal preference. I've sort of worked it out that I like about 7 hours. So basically 6 or 7 hours out, you have your biggest meal here. Then half the time, you have a meal half the size, so like 3, 3.5 hours out. And then like 1.5, 2 hours out, you have like a small carb-based snack. So that's where you see the people with their bananas, their Rice Krispie Squares are booming at the moment. Wish I fucking bought shares and then. there's a boom in Ireland, the Rice Krispie Squares. And then caffeine or something before the game as well. So yeah, basically 7 o'clock now is 6 hours out. So we'll have this and then I'll have something at 10. And then 9 o'clock. 10, 11, 12, yeah, I'll go 9 o'clock. My mom's is shocking. So yeah, I'll have something at 9 o'clock. I'm gonna have oats then with basically similar to what I showed you yesterday, but I'll just have less oats with it. So I'll have a protein shake and oats there. And then before the game, I'll have the usual banana, squirt bars, probably still a few jelly babies in the change room as well. And then it's in the game time. So yeah, it's very simple for breakfast. Scrambled eggs on toast, scrambled eggs on bagel. The open the bread, fucking blue mold all over it. So, straighten it in. But yeah.
Dumb.
Right, so pre-game stats here. Gonna run you through what we have before every game, every training session. Not every training session, but every game anyway. So first up, we've got collagen. So that's for the tendons, hamstring tendons, Achilles tendons give me a bit of jip at times. So getting that in before any lower body loading is great. So usually take about an hour before, but on the way to the game, I'll just take it on the way to the game. So I have it done and in me. So that goes in here. Then we have our pre-game snack, carb-based snack, just square bar and a banana. Don't know if I'm feeling a banana today though. Have that about an hour and a half, 2 hours out. And then here we've got our gels. So isotonic gels basically just does the same job as Lucozade, but easier to get in. Not as much volume. So I'll have one throughout the warm-up just before the game, one at half time, and then an optional one midway through the second half if I feel like I need it. And then we have electrolytes in here, just keep making sure hydration is topped up. And then on top of that, we're just sipping throughout water. I've had my meals today, so two main meals, scrambled eggs and toast this morning, porridge with honey and protein shake on the side, protein smoothie with banana, protein powder, almond milk and frozen blueberries. So yeah, feeling good, ready to go. I'll have a coffee here, probably get the square bar into me, and then it's I'll do a bit of journaling before the match, just sort of writing a few things down, a few messages, how I sort of want the game to go, what my role is, just getting clear on that, a few finishing touches, all the work's done, and yeah, then we'll be making our way to the pitch. So yeah, chat to you soon.
So game wrapped up, got the win, absolutely delighted with the win. Brutal personal performance, on my first thought of it. Decent first half, second half just not great at all. I picked up a black card as well, so
bit disappointed personally with my own personal performance, but fucking buzzing, we got the win. So looking forward to the semi-final now next week. So next couple of days, just get recovered, get the body right, getting refueled, rehydrated, getting the carbs back in, getting plenty of protein in here tonight, get a good night's sleep, give the body the best chance for recovery, and then I'm sure we'll probably be back training on Tuesday. Looking forward to semi-final in Croke Park next week. So yeah, happy enough, glad they've got the win, but as I say, disappointed personally, but fuck it, on to the next one. Come on.
So a week later then, we went to Croke Park to play Meath in the semi-final, and fuck me, what an experience. Croke Park is an absolute carpet, best pitch in Ireland by far, best place I've ever played in, and actually enjoyed the occasion rather than maybe hyping myself up too much. Unfortunately, we got beat by 2 points, so that marked the end of our county season. What a run. Bit disappointed that we didn't get the win because we did only get beat by 2 points, but gives us some serious hope for the future. So, just wanted to say thanks very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Hopefully, you took some valuable insights, learned a few lessons, and just enjoyed sort of going behind the scenes of what happens on a game weekend, how it looks, how it's sort of set up. Hopefully, you take a few lessons that you can use yourself to improve. If you have any questions on anything at all throughout the video, whether it's carb loading, primers, just anything at all I mentioned, feel free to drop a comment or drop me a message on Instagram. Be happy to chat with you there. And in terms of the next video, let me know what you want to see more of. Bit about where I'm at the moment. I'm actually heading away on holiday, so by the time you watch this, I'll probably be away. So I might get a wee bit of traveling updates, training while on holiday. But if there's anything S&C related, anything sort of GAA training, S&C related, please let me know, or ask me any questions, give me some suggestions. But as I say, thanks very much for tuning in. Appreciate the support. Please share it with a teammate who you think would enjoy it. Massively appreciate if you could share it on your socials, drop me a tag there. And yeah, make sure you subscribe, like the video, comment, all that sort of jazz. But again, just thanks very much for the support. Hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Good luck.